Hi, I'm Keith Jerome. I'm a scientist at the Fred Hutch Cancer Research Center in Seattle, and I've worked for many years on herpes virus infections. As you may know, October 13th is National Herpes Awareness Day, and I've been asked to take just a minute or two and talk with you about some of the efforts that we're making and other scientists in the field are making to find a cure for herpes virus infections. The first thing I'd like you to know is that there are a lot of talented scientists working on these infections. Many are working on vaccines. We've heard a lot about vaccines over the recent months with the COVID pandemic and seen how fast sometimes things can happen. A vaccine for herpes is going to be much more difficult to develop, unfortunately. Herpes is really great at evading the immune system. And I certainly hope that the folks working on those are successful. They've been working a long time, and I certainly wish them the best. Our own work isn't to prevent herpes with a vaccine, it's actually to cure it in people who already have the infection. So we're taking a different approach. We're using something called gene editing to attack the virus where it lives. We think about herpes as a skin infection, but it's really not. It lives in the nerves that innervate the affected regions. And with gene editing, we can actually introduce very specialized proteins into the nerves that innervate the region. And these proteins go in and they look for herpes. And if they find it, they cut the virus up into little pieces that the body can then eliminate. And we've been doing this for a couple of years now in mice and have had some really exciting results. We can eliminate the vast majority of herpes from latently infected mice. More recently, we're starting to move into studies in guinea pigs. Guinea pigs have herpes infections that are even more similar to humans than the mice are. So we're really excited by this. And the goal is to move this from just animal studies into something that we can do in human beings. We want to do a human clinical trial. Before we can do that, we need to get the therapy working just as well as we possibly can. We want to get that last little bit of leftover herpes if we can. And we need to be sure this is safe. We want to make sure that nobody gets hurt from this. So this has taken a lot of resources over several years now. We've had support recently from the US government through the National Institutes of Health. But before we could convince them that this was valid and something worth doing, we had support from private foundations interested in these infections. And we've had a bunch of support from individuals who care about these infections. And if any of you who've supported the work are listening to this, thank you so much. I will tell you that this has moved the work forward much faster than it ever could have happened, than it could have happened otherwise. Going forward, this is something we're not going to give up on. We're going to work on this till we get it, till we come up with a cure. But we need to do this together. And those of you in the community who care about these infections, make your voice heard. Let your government representatives know you want a cure for herpes. You want research to be happening. We want more scientists to be involved. If you have contacts in the pharmaceutical industry, let them know. We want a cure. We want to support this research. We all need to do our part in this. The scientists will be working in the labs, doing everything we can to figure out the problem. If you advocate while we do the work, I really believe together we can pull and bring an end to these infections that have affected so many people. So thank you so much. Let's put an end to herpes once and for all.